All right, so chances are you probably do not know the name Saul Hudson, but you would know him by his nickname, Slash. The guitarist currently for Velvet Revolver and Guns N' Roses fame as well has authored a new book.
Yeah, you can learn everything here in this new book, and Slash joins us now this morning from New York. So Slash, tell us something that's in this book that people are totally surprised by.
Actually, off the top of my head, I can't think of. I think they're really surprised at the fact that I put such a tell-all tale together. You know, not a tale, but you know, put all my information as I remember it in a book.
As you remember it. Okay. Yeah. Two things that surprised me, though. One is that you've had a heart condition, and second is, as growing up as a kid, you were a big BMX fan.
I was actually a pro BMX racer all the way up until I started playing guitar.
And in the heart condition, did that change your life?
It changed it for a minute. that was back in 2000, 2001, and it was something that came about from excessive drinking. It wasn't really a heart condition that I had all my life. It was something that I basically did to myself. And so, that was a big scare. The doctor said I had anywhere from 6 days to 6 weeks to live. But miraculously, I managed to pull through it. And during that period where I was rehabilitating, I sort of cleaned up my act and so on and so forth. But then, slowly but surely, I got back into my old habits and all the way up until about a year ago, and then I finally just cleaned it all up.
So why did you decide to write the book? I mean, why now, and why give up so much info?
It's basically the result of so much brouhaha going on about Guns N' Roses ever since Velvet Revolver started. Because I'm in the public eye so much and I do a lot of interviews, I get asked a lot of questions about Guns N' Roses that apparently people don't know. And then on top of that, there's so many rumors going around about the band getting back together, or actually, in fact, had gotten back together at one point. And a lot of other things. And it just got frustrating to spend so much time doing press and finding out that there was so much BS going on, and I finally decided that I needed to set the record straight on my own behalf, you know, and also to give the fans some information that was truthful as opposed to what they were being fed on the internet and by the tabloids and the different rock magazines and so on.
I gotta be honest, Slash, when you think of a rock and roll guitarist and you think of the stereotype, you've pretty much lived that stereotype.
Oh yeah.
That you remember anyway.
Yeah, right. Well, I'm surprised I'm surprised I remember as much as I do. It's the amount of recall that I have actually was astounding.
So did you like the writing process? I mean, I know you had a co-author in the book, but you had to sit down at a computer at some point and start banging out this stuff. Did you enjoy
yeah,
that?
Yeah, it was a lot more complicated than I expected it to be. I was sort of naive going into it, didn't know anything about the process of writing a book. And I thought it would be really simple. I thought I'd be interviewed by the co-writer, and then he would just write it all down, and we'd put it out, and that would be it. And it turned out not to be the case. In order for me to get my true voice in there, I had to get my hands dirty and really write.
All right. Well, hey, thanks for joining us
today. In bookstores now, Slash, we appreciate it. Have a good day, sir.
Thanks for having me. See ya.
All right, on to movies now.
You
Mr. Movie Phone?
He was a big surprise.
Really?
I thought so, yeah. I thought that was really fun.
Interesting thing we also learned about him, his mother did costumes for David Bowie,
mm-hmm.
and his father was also in the industry. He is literally from England, or initially from England,
yeah.
and moved to L.A.
And he
as
grew
a kid.
Up around musicians and around some of the biggest ones.